Hello, myself Sarita Shetty. Today we'll be doing lesson number 20, communication. What do you mean by communication, children? Communication means sharing of ideas, information or messages, right? Let us see what ancient people, how did they communicated, okay? In the ancient times, people sent messages through messengers. Now, this messenger went either on foot or traveled on horseback or even on a camel. Or even a camel was used to convey the message. In some places, messages were sent by tying them to the feet of trained pigeon. Right. Now, why do we need to send messages? We need them to share news, messages and feelings and keep in touch with our friends and relatives. So, we need one means of communication. Now, what are the means of communication, children? Can you all tell me? Right. First of all, you will tell me telephone. Telephone is the nowadays main means of communication. Pick up the telephone and call and ask how they are. Whatever messages you want to pass, you pass it. Letter, telephone, newspapers, book, magazine, radio, television, computer, and internet are some of the means of communications. Now, letter. Let us see about the letter. How can we communicate with the help of letter? We communicate by writing letters. We may use inline letters and postcards for this. We buy them from the post office. Right? Inline letter, what you see in a blue color, it is called as an inline letter. And a postcard, what you see in yellow color, it is called as a postcard. Less nowadays, we are using very less use of these things. Right? And where you can go and buy this, we can buy this in the post office. Now let us see about the telephone. Telephone is a quickest means of communication. We can talk directly to a person using a landline phone or a mobile phone. We can also send a written messages called SMS through a mobile phone. What else we can do, children? Not even messages, now WhatsApp has come. Immediately, photographs, messages, your voice messages, anything we can share through WhatsApp. And that means with the mobile phone. Right. Now next is we can send written messages quickly through a fax machine. Right. After telephone came fax machine. Immediately whatever you want to fax, you want to mail bills, you want to send quotations. So we can use this fax machine. A fax machine needs a telephone number to work. Then all over the world, what is going on? How do we come to know? Through internet also we come to know. And the main thing, early morning, what we get? We get newspapers. So, newspapers, books and magazines. We communicate written messages to a large number of people through newspapers, books and magazines. We get to know about what is happening in the world through them, right? Next is radio and television. Okay, still radios are going on. And television, of course, you people are always in the front of television. Right? What is radio useful? How it is useful? Radio and television also give information about news and events to a large number of people at the same time. We can only listen to a radio while we can also see programs on a television. Right? Now, in front of television, you are supposed to sit, but on radio, you can carry radio anywhere. While doing work also, you can hear the news, what is going all around the world. We can only receive messages, but cannot send our messages through newspapers, books and magazines, radios and television. Can we send back whatever news we have? No. Whatever messages they are giving, we can only hear them. Even the newspapers, books and magazines, radios and television. Previously on television, we used to have one particular time and on that particular time only we used to hear or watch news. Nowadays, whole day, 24 hours, 24 into 7, right? We can hear the news, what is going all over the world. And there are 10 to 20 news channels are there which are going. Right, and we can see all these news 24 into 7. Right, Now let us see about the internet. What is internet, children? All of you know through internet today pandemic situation, what are we doing? With the help of the internet, we are conducting our lectures, we are conducting our interaction sessions, right? So internet is so important. Internet is the latest means of communication. It connects different computers of the world. We can send emails and get information about various things on our computer, laptop, mobile phones off because of internet, right? On the computer, what are we doing? We are taking classes, we are exchanging information, we are giving exams, right? Teachers are imparting education to the children. So nowadays, smartphone is a good quality screen and internet connection have become popular as fastest means of communication. Those who do not have laptops, right, PCs, what they are doing? They are doing it on mobile phones. And mobile phones are so clear and they have a very good quality of a screen. We can even see the person we are talking to with the help of web cameras fitted in them, right? Through video calls, what we can do, with whom we are talking, we can also see them. Now let us see some of the communications at public places. Most people have their own means of communication which only they can use. However, some public places such as market, railway stations and airport have common means of communication. Anyone can use them by paying money, right? People use public phone booths to make calls. Nowadays it is all closed. Public booths are not there. First we used to have STD internet cafes to send emails or to get information. Even that has been reduced. Why? Because on the mobile phone only we have all these facilities. Previously it was not there, so we used to go to the internet cafes, right, to mail the information to a particular person. People also share their ideas at public places by giving speeches, lectures or staging plays, right? Now we go for the seminars. What they do, what we get, one person is standing in front of us and he is giving speech. So what does he do? He is sharing his views or he is sharing his knowledge to the people by speeches, lectures, right? Now let us see communication for entertainment. Radio and televisions are the two oldest means of entertainment. We hear songs, other programs on video, right? What do? We hear songs. Still radios are on. Your mother and father, you may not be using radio, but your parents must be still using radios to hear old songs, right? Televisions, you all people continuously want to sit in front of television, so that is one of the entertainment part. We hear and see songs, dance, dramas, sports programs and movies on televisions. We also read books and magazines to relax ourselves, correct? We also read magazines. How many of you all like to read? I don't think so you people read, but you should read magazines, small magazines for the children you all get. Start reading, so you will feel relaxed, okay? Now, due to internet, music and videos are easily available all the time. People can also play a variety of games anytime using the internet. Let us see ways to check misuse of communication. Now, we will see what are the ways of misuse. Can you all tell me what are the ways of misuse? How it has been misused? Now, first of all, I will tell you communication misuse. Hours and hours you people sit in front of TV. That is one of the misused communication entertainment part, right? Now, let us read from the textbook. Communication has made our life easy, but sometimes we misuse the means of communication by spending too much time on them, right? Now, textbook is also saying too much time you're spending in front of the TV, which is not good at all for your body. and for your mental health also. While driving or walking on the road, right? Do not spend all your free time in playing with these devices. Do some outdoor activities and spend time with your family and friends also, instead of sitting in front of that idiot box. I'll say it is an idiot box, dabba it is, okay? Do not sit in front of that for the longer time. And do some outdoor activities or help your parents in their household works instead of sitting in front of the TV. Okay. Do not talk loudly on phone so that others are not disturbed. Okay. When you talk loudly on the phone, the sitting people next to you are disturbed. So avoid that. Avoid using too much of these devices. It is bad for your eyes. Okay, your eyes will get strained. Very early age, you will get spectacles. Use them only when necessary. Pay attention to your studies and outdoor games first. Okay, use them only when necessary. Only for a while you can use them, not for the longer times. What you should do, pay attention to your studies. Whatever studies are given to you, first you complete, play, help your parents, and then only sit in front of the TV only for half an hour to 1 hour. That's all, not more than that. Okay, and try to play outdoor games, right? So I hope I have made you clear what is a communication and what are the advantages and disadvantages, right? I want you all to go through the video again and again to understand better. Okay, thank you. I end this lesson here.